If you are new here, I'm Kaniti, and if you're already watching this channel, welcome back. Today we are going to watch 18th episode of Anime Steins Gate, so let's get to it. Let's go. Alright, let's see. Will we now go to Rukaka? Yes, exactly. I thought she might not even believe him, right? Like, imagine someone just coming up to you, even if it's someone close to you, and saying that, and you would be like, what? That's, yeah, I thought about it in the previous episode. So now we are undoing all these wishes, and Rukaka, when she was technically a guy, she was really unhappy with that, right? She wanted to be just born a girl right away. And so that was her wish, and we did manage to make it come true. Again, it's something very important to her. So just as with Fairies-chan, it was also like super heavy. Because it was about like life of her dad, so it was obviously like maybe more serious, more hard to like let go of. But for Rukaka, it's also something very important. So if she does believe Ocarine, that would mean she would have to say goodbye to her female form, right? So she'll have to become technically a guy again and just put on girl's clothes, kind of just visually pretending to be a girl. So obviously, again, she will not be very accepting of doing that if that happens, but I assume fractal androgynous. I assume in the end she would still say yes and kind of agree, but it would be a hard decision. I guess that's where it's going. She complained. Oh. Well, he didn't technically say that. He said she used to be a guy. But if this all goes to him destroying, like undoing all the D-mails, he will undo the very first one. And then Makise would die. Because he did find her dead. But after the D-mail, it's changed. About like eating vegetables or not eating vegetables, it was something very silly. She's always so sweet. What is going on? I don't understand what they're talking about. So she likes him? Well, I guess there were implications for that from the very beginning, yeah. She was getting like very shy and everything. He's a very popular guy. How unexpected. She deserves better though. I like her so much. Maybe also because she likes him, she's more like prone to believe in him, in what he says. That's very straightforward. Just for one day. Ah, and then I'm doing this. So they're going to go on a date. No, go on a date with me. Not with him. How is this even going to look? I'm curious. Are there also like romantic lines in this visual novel? Yeah, because there are a lot of girls who kind of potentially could be interested in him, so it looks also like a visual novel where you can pursue different characters. Ultimate technique? I don't understand what she means. So he kissed them in the games. That's all very serious dates. This would make me nervous. Yeah. Do something more simple, or you would both be uncomfortable. Really? Okay, there's no need to shame him about this. And they're both pretty young. I'm distracted by his game. Yeah, there's nothing wrong about it. And you can just go on dates without that. Yeah. Wait, is she like reading a book with tips? Maybe go like to a park or to a main street. Oh, that's the same scene as from the game. Isn't, I guess, yeah. Okay. Does this happen? He has very serious clothes. There are some very interesting rules I didn't know about. She looks super pretty. Think even when we met her the first time in the anime, I also felt that he kinda likes her. Even though he saw her as a guy and someone he wouldn't be interested in, there was some kind of spark. Protect. Yeah, he's very subtle. So they came to drink some tea. This looks nice. This seems like a nice place. Oh, and cake! Now that's a good place for a date. Ah, coffee, okay. The coffee is fine too. Yeah, because the situation is different. He's nervous, so he doesn't know what to say. Capable of answering questions. Yeah, I think it's also like here being implied among other hints that Makisa also likes him. So, this episode is kind of more lighthearted in this sense and more about romance than like it kind of the main plot. Accosted? Wait. But wouldn't that be in a different line? Yeah. So did she actually? Huh, feel kind of strange. Yeah, so she's remembering actually the memories from another from the last world line, right? So, I guess that was the reason why she liked him. At least in that line, world line. Maybe in this world line something similar has happened, just without the conversation about being a guy. Ah, so trying to make this message out as a prank. Someone? You didn't recognize him? Like he was pretending to be someone that he was not. But now he came like as himself in his normal clothes. Student, okay. She seems to be impressed. Are they training? Daru is like, what the heck? And they're still spying on him. So it was here, but then broken, and I guess tossed out in this world line that we are in right now. But she remembered the memories from another world line. So it really is possible for anyone to recall some of the memories. Okay, what number we will have now? Oh, it's changed now. Yeah, she's super cute, like, so sweet. We're almost at the end of the episode. I think we saw like the number change in his eyes, but we didn't see what it has changed to. But I would assume it went a bit up, like it was 0.4, maybe it went to 0.5, maybe a bit higher. But in any case, a few things I wanted to say. First of all, if there is like, if I don't look at it like a visual novel with different options, if I look at Ocarina as his own character and personality, and what I've seen from him, I would say the person he would be want to be with is Mayushi. I think this is someone that is the most precious to him. For me, just Mayushi is like an angel. She's super sweet, she's super cute, she's just like perfect all around. But yeah, when I look at her, I see her more as a child, I think. Maybe also because she acts more childish. And yeah, they are all like in their age, they all should look like children to me, I think. It's just how they are drawn, they look a bit older. Like Ocarina, for example, I thought he is an older guy, and then I turned out to be wrong, right? And Rukaka, meanwhile, she looks more mature, I would say, in how she's drawn and also in how she behaves. So I really like her a lot. I think she's very sweet and very cute. And also in this day and age, she could do, maybe that's something like she wouldn't want. Of course, she would prefer to be born as a girl, but she could do some kind of surgery, right? Take some pills, and then she would be not only visually but technically also more like a woman, and maybe she would feel quite comfortable. Maybe it wouldn't be as perfect as she would want if she was just born a woman, but it would still be something. And also this episode gave me like this serious like visual novel vibes, because also with the previous episode also we saw Fairies-chan kind of show interest in Ocarina, and it really looked like there are these options, so to say. There are different characters that are interested in the main character, and so you could with your choices and your actions kind of choose one of the paths and get the ending with this person. Because before that we were mostly, yeah, there were these little romantic moments and hints in the first meeting with Rukaka, in many scenes with Makise, and also of course we see that Ocarina is close to Mayushi. I don't think there were many hints with Fairies before that, but in any case, it was mostly about the main plot, and it seemed to be me like, if it's firstly a novel, right? That's a novel about this time changes, time travels, time everything, right? that's what the plot centers around. But with this episode combined with the previous one, I thought, oh, maybe there's like some romantic lines, and here we are kind of exploring them, and that gives also. When you see them all being explored kind of at once in parallel, it gives some harem vibes, which is a bit strange in the anime with this main plot line. So that was a bit, maybe a bit unexpected to me, but I enjoyed this episode because it was very fun and I saw a lot of Rukaku, which is always a plus. And yeah, a bit more going in depth on Okarin himself and his personality, who he is, because as you know, at first when I met him, I didn't really like him. I thought he's a pretty mean guy, and how he was talking to Makisa and to other characters, and I didn't really appreciate that. But then if you go deeper and look at his like base values, he is a very good person. He's about protecting those who are precious to them. He's trying to make them feel comfortable, to make them feel bad. He doesn't want them to be hurt. He tried to protect fairies, even though he was badly beaten up. He tried to protect Rukako's feelings here. And yeah, I think we also saw that moment when he met Rukako and when he said it doesn't matter if you are a guy and a girl, which kind of made her feel impressed. So we see him more as this like a more multifaceted character, a person who has something bad and something good at him, like a real person. That's really interesting. Like, while Mayushi is, for example, she's just perfect. She doesn't have any bad qualities. As I said, she's just like an angel. She can't do no wrong. She can't do no wrong. Meanwhile, in Ocarina, we see like a real human being that could be kind of mean or something like that, but he also can be kind. And that is more interesting as a character, right? I still like Mayushi a lot. I'm just saying that is more interesting, and that you are trying to kind of analyze them and think about that. So that's really curious. But as I also mentioned before, I think Mayushi being this perfect is also on purpose, because you can't not like her. So when she dies, it's not only us as viewers, we want her to be okay, we don't want her to die. So obviously we are on board with all of this, but also explains why other characters care about her. Or if something bad is going to happen to Mayushi, then alright, I will give up on this dream for her. And her being this super sweet and super nice girl explains all these characters around her making sacrifices for her. Okay, I'm just starting to write my own analysis. Yeah, I think that's mostly all that I wanted to say. I'm afraid if I continue, I will just go down all of my analysis points and write a whole dissertation, or how it's called in English. I think it's just called like this dissertation, like a whole work study. I don't know. Okay, that would be it for this episode. Very excited to see the next one. And yeah, as I also mentioned before in the episode, if we're undoing all the D-mails, we'll have to undo the D-mail that made Makisa Kurisu like not dead, right? So I think that's what we are coming towards, and this is pretty scary. Okay, so with that's really it for today. Please share your thoughts without spoilers, of course, in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and see ya!